Today we are going to discuss about the domain of a function. So first we have to understand what is domain. At which region a function is defined, this region is called domain. So first, suppose this is a function fx is equal to x square minus 5x plus 6 by x square minus 8x plus 12. We have to find the domain of this function. That is, at which region this function is defined. So, if x square minus 8x plus 12 is equal to 0, it is very obvious that fx will be undefined. So, first we find the point at which x square minus 8x plus 12 is equal to 0. And it will be x minus 2 and x minus 6 is equal to 0. That is, x is equal to 2 or x is equal to 6. So it is very obvious for the value of 2 and 6 of x, this function is undefined. So the domain of the function will be real number set minus. So, we find the domain of this function by eliminating these two points, 2 and 6, from the real number set. So, domain of this function, domain of fx will be real number set minus 2, 6. Now, if you find domain of root over x square minus 5x plus 6. If we find the domain of x square minus 5x plus 6, so we know that if it is fx, then fx have real value if x square minus 5x plus 6 greater than equals to 0. So if x square minus 5x plus 6 less than 0, then it will be root over of some minus which belongs to complex number. So for real number we have to find the x for which x square minus 5x plus 6 greater than equals to 0. That is, fx will be defined when or we get a value of fx, a real number, when x square minus 5x plus 6 greater than equals to 0. Now, x square minus 3x minus 2x, x minus 3 plus 2 into x minus 3 greater than 0, and x minus 3 into x minus 2 greater than equals to 0. That is, x minus 3 greater than equals to 0. If we draw a OAB curve, then it will be very clear. Suppose this is 2 and this is 3. At which portion the value of this expression, will be greater than equals to 0. If we take 1, then 1 minus 3 and 1 minus 2. 1 minus 3 and 1 minus 2. Both are negative. Negative into negative, that will be positive. That is, if 0, 1, this will be positive. Now, 2.5, we choose a point 2.5. 2.5 minus 3, that will be negative. So, in this region, this value of this function will be negative. And suppose 4 minus 3 into 4 minus 2, that will be greater than 0. So, in this region, the value of this expression is positive. So at which region x minus 3 into x minus 2 greater than equals to 0, we may write that the domain of this function will be minus infinity up to 2. Why I take this closed interval? As we know, at the point 2, the expression will be 0. Root over 0 is defined. Union 3 to positive infinity. So, domain of this function will be please check. Now, if we do another sum, suppose log of 2 plus x by 2 minus x base e. Log of 2 plus x by 2 minus x base e. Find the domain of this function. So, how we calculate this? We know that log x is defined when x greater than 0. So it is very clear 2 by x by 2 minus x greater than 0 to be, if we find the domain of fx and we as we know that log x base e is defined when x greater than 0, so by this rule 2 plus x by 2 minus x greater than 0. Now if 2 plus x greater than 0 and 2 minus x greater than 0, then if both that is numerator and denominator both greater than 0, then it will be greater than 0. Otherwise 2 plus x less than 0 and 2 minus x less than 0. From these two conditions we find x. So 2 plus x greater than 0 gives x greater than minus 2 and 2 minus x greater than 0 gives 2 greater than x. That is x greater than minus 2 and x less than 2. X greater than minus 2 and x less than 2. And from this 2 plus x less than 0, that is x less than minus 2 and x less than minus 2 and x greater than 2. X less than minus 2 and x greater than 2 both simultaneously cannot be hold. So our domain will be minus 2, 2, as x greater than 2 and x less than minus 2, which is not possible. So our domain will be this. Now, if we do another sum, suppose it is given that fx is equal to 1 by root of fx. Fx is equal to 1 by root over x minus mod x. First, we calculate the value of x minus mod of x. X minus mod of x is equal to x minus x when x greater than 0. That is x minus mod x is equal to 0 when x greater than 0. This is case 1. And if x minus mod x is equal इक्वल टू एक्स माइनस ऑफ माइनस एक्स व्हेन एक्स लेस देन जीरो दैट इज टू एक्स व्हेन एक्स लेस देन जीरो दैट इज एक्स एक्स माइनस मॉड ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो व्हेन एक्स ग्रेटर देन जीरो फॉर ऑल एक्स बिलोंग्स टू रियल नंबर ग्रेटर देन जीरो फॉर ऑल एक्स बिलोंग्स टू पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर एक्स माइनस मॉड एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड फॉर ऑल एक्स बिलोंग्स टू नेगेटिव रियल नंबर वी गेट ए नेगेटिव रियल नंबर टू एक्स सो एंड फॉर एक्स माइनस मॉड एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो सो हियर वी सी द थ्री केसेस फर्स्ट केस इफ एक्स इज ए पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर इफ एक्स इज ए पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर देन इफ एक्स इज ए पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर देन प्लीज नोट दिस इफ एक्स इज ए पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर देन एक्स माइनस मॉड एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो If x is a negative real number, then it is a negative number, that is 2x less than 0. And if x is equal to 0, it again 0. That is, fx cannot be defined. If we want to get any real value of x from this function, we cannot get any real x. For all x belongs to real number, we cannot get any real value of fx for x belongs to real number. That is, we cannot define the domain of this. Domain of fx is equal to null set. I explain again. If we take x which is greater than 0, we get x minus mod x is equal to 0. That is, 1 by 0 is undefined. That is, in this region, fx is not defined. Okay? Now, come to the second case. If x less than 0, then x minus mod x is equal to 2x. That is a negative real number, and we know root over of negative real number gives complex number, so we cannot get any real value for all x belongs to negative real number. So here for the case 2 we get a complex number, so we do not define this portion as a domain. So fx is not defined when x less than 0, and if x is equal to 0, then x minus mod x is equal to 0, that is 1 by 0 is undefined. So here it is very obvious for any real x, whether it is positive or negative or 0, we do not get any domain for the function fx. So the domain of fx is a null set. If fx is equal to 1 by root over x plus mod x, like previous example, x plus mod x is equal to x plus x when x greater than 0, that is 2x, which is greater than 0, and x plus mod x is equal to x minus x when x less than 0, that is 0, and x plus mod x is equal to 0 when x is equal to 0. Like previous example, here we do three cases. First case, x greater than 0. Second case, x less than 0. Third case, x equals to 0. It is very obvious that if x less than 0, then x plus mod of x is equal to 0. And if x is equal to 0, then x plus mod x also 0. So that is, for x less than 0 or x equals to 0, 1 by root over x plus small x cannot be defined. So for all x belongs to positive real number, for all x belongs to positive real number, this function fx is defined. So domain of fx will be 0 to positive infinity or positive real number set. So I explain again, it is given fx is equal to 1 by x plus mod x. First we calculate the value of x plus mod x, which is 2x, and as x greater than 0, this 2x always greater than 0. So 1 by greater than 0 we get a x from this function, but if x less than 0, then 1 by x plus mod x will be 0. 1 by root over of 0, 1 by root over 0, that is 1 by 0, which is undefined. So in this region, that is x less than 0, that is for all x belongs to negative real number, we cannot define fx at this region. And if x is equal to 0, also x plus mod x will be 0. So for x is equal to 0, this function is not defined. So at which region this function is defined? For all x belongs to positive real number, that is open interval 0 to positive infinity. Now it is given fx is equal to x by log of 1 plus x. So first, to define the function fx, log of 1 plus x not equals to 0, and to define log of 1 plus x we get 1 plus x greater than 0. That is, you should remember that here two case arises. First case, this function is defined only when log of 1 plus x not equals to 0. And we know that log x is defined at which region? Log x is defined, log x base e, suppose it, this is e. Log x base e is defined when x greater than 0, that is 1 plus x greater than 0. So we have to satisfy these two conditions. So from this we get x greater than minus 1, and as log of 1 plus x not equals to 0, if x plus 1, if x plus 1 is equal to 1, then we know x is equal to 0, that is for x is equal to 0, log of 1 plus x will be, log of 1 will be 0. So at this point, you should remember this portion, which is very important. If x is equal to 0, then log of 1 plus x will be 0, and we know that 1 by 0 is undefined. So we have to satisfy two conditions. First condition, x greater than minus 1 and x not equals to 0. We have to satisfy these two conditions. As for x is equal to 0, this portion will be 0. So why this will be 0? As we know, log of 1 is equal to 0. We know that log of 1 is equal to 0. So if x plus 1 is equal to 1, then x is equal to 0. That is, if x is equal to 0, log of 1 plus x will be 0. So to define this function, x must not be 0 and x greater than minus 1. From these two conditions, we get that the domain of x, the domain of this function will be, the domain of this function will be minus 1 to 0 union 0 to positive infinity. So please remember these two conditions. Now it is given that one by fx is equal to one by cos x minus sin x. 1 by cos x minus sin x. To find the domain, first fx is undefined, fx is undefined when cos x minus sin x is equal to 0. If this portion is 0, then it is very obvious that fx cannot be defined. So fx is undefined when cos x minus sin x is equal to 0. That is, sin x is equal to cos x. That is, tan x is equal to 1. That is, tan x is equal to tan pi by 4. If we find the general solution, this will be x is equal to n pi plus pi by 4 for all n is equal to 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, dot, dot. So, at this point, this function is not defined. So, what will be the domain? It is very obvious that the domain will be real number minus, if we omit this point from the real number set, then the function will be defined. So, the domain of this function will be, domain will be R minus such point n pi plus pi by 4, where n is equal to 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 dot dot, that is n belongs to integer. So what will be the domain of this function? R minus n pi plus pi by 4. So that is the class of, so in this class I will discuss about domain and different types of function, domain of different types of function. So tomader jodi bhalo lege thake, please like koro ar bondhuder shonge share koro. Ei je chapter ta ajke amra korlam, ei chapter ta tomader class test ba class 11 er je board exam hocche ekhon, sei board exam er jonno khub important. Particular ekhan theke JEE mains e ekta question aste pare, to tomra jar jekhane problem hocche video ta pause kore kore dekhe niyo. Ajke ami different types er problem niye alochona korlam. Next class e amra range niye alochona korbo. তোমাদের হাফ ইয়ারলির জন্য বারবার বলছি, এই ডোমেন আর রেঞ্জ থেকে যে কোনো হাফ, যে কোনো স্কুলের পরীক্ষা, সেটা টেকনো ইন্ডিয়া বলো, ডন বস্কো বলো, অক্সিলিয়াম বলো, টিটিবি বলো, জোসেফ বলো, এবং যে কোনো ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল বোর্ডেরও যে কোনো স্কুলে হাফ ইয়ারলি পরীক্ষার জন্য এই পোর্শনগুলো ডোমেন আর পরের দিন আমরা রেঞ্জ নিয়ে আলোচনা করব। এই টপিকগুলো খুব ইম্পর্টেন্ট, তোমরা রেগুলার ক্লাসটা আমার ফলো করো। মাঝখানে আমার কয়েকদিন একটু অফ গেছে, শরীর খারাপ ছিল আর কি, এক সপ্তাহ একটু রেস্ট নিতে বলেছিল ডাক্তার, তো হয়তো অনেকদিন ভিডিও পোস্ট করা হয়নি, আপলোড করা হয়নি। আর যাদের যেখানে প্রবলেম হচ্ছে তোমরা মেনশন করো একটু, আর ফেসবুক পেজেও আমি রেগুলার আপডেট দিতে থাকছি। আর যাদের যেখানে প্রবলেম হচ্ছে বারবার বলছি, পার্টিকুলার মেসেজ করো আমাকে, হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ নাম্বারও দেওয়া আছে, তোমাদের যাতে ভালো হয় তার জন্যই ক্লাসগুলো নেওয়া। এবং প্রত্যেকে সিরিয়াসলি এটা ফলো করো, এবং এই অঙ্কগুলোর সাথে সাথে তোমরা যদি বইয়েরটা, বইয়ের অঙ্কগুলো নিজেরা করার চেষ্টা করো, এবং নিজেরা যদি করতে পারো তাহলে দেখবে খুব ভালো লাগবে। তো আশা করি
প্রবলেম হবে না, ডোমেনের আরো কিছু টাইপ বাকি রইল, সেগুলো তোমরা নিজেরা বাড়ি থেকে বাড়িতে চেষ্টা করো। এই ভিডিওর সঙ্গে তোমাদের স্কুলের পরীক্ষার জন্য কিছু এমসিকিউ আমি দিয়ে দিচ্ছি, পিডিএফ ফরম্যাটে হয়তো দেবো, তার লিঙ্কটা আমার ডিসক্রিপশন বক্সেই থাকবে, সেখানে হয়তো 40-15-20 মতো কোশ্চেন থাকতে পারে, তো তোমরা বাড়িতে ওইগুলো একটু বাড়িতে সলভ করো। তো যেই এই যে কোশ্চেন পেপারগুলো দিচ্ছি এগুলো তোমাদের স্কুলের যে হাফ ইয়ারলি যে এক্সাম হবে বা ধরো অনলাইনে যে এক্সামগুলো স্কুল কনডাক্ট করবে সেখানে দেখবে এই টাইপের অঙ্কই থাকবে, আর যেই মেন্সের জন্য খুবই ইম্পর্টেন্ট ওই কোশ্চেনগুলো। তো ক্লাস যদি ভালো লেগে থাকে বা যদি আমার কিছু বোঝাতে মানে বোঝানো ঠিক হচ্ছে না বলে মনে হয় তোমাদের, সেটাও একটু কমেন্ট বক্সে লিখো। আবার রেগুলার আপডেট করতে থাকবো, মাঝখানে বললাম ব্রেক হয়ে গেছিল। ঠিক আছে, আজকের মতো এখানেই, আবার দেখা হবে নেক্সট ক্লাসে। নেক্সট ক্লাস আমরা মোস্ট প্রবাবলি রেঞ্জ নিয়ে আরম্ভ করবো। ওকে, থ্যাংক ইউ।